Hi people, welcome to this video. Let's see how to add keyframes and basic effects with Cyberlink PowerDirector 13. If you need help just at a specific feature, use the quick index in video description and skip what you don't need. Let's see the keyframes. These are very important to change properties in time. When you use the PIP designer, you do have a local timeline below. This lasts as much as the interested clip does, which is represented by a green row on top. Below such row, you have other rows, each dedicated to each property inside Object Settings section. Opacity, Scale, Rotation, and so on. Let's take opacity for example. Nothing changes with the other properties. As long as you use the bars on the left, you will change opacity all along the clip's duration. If you want to change it in time, simply move the local playhead and fix the keyframes using the yellow rhombus on the left. The meaning of the keyframes is simple. The keyframe is a point that saves the status of the property in the instant of time it is placed, so that if you put two keyframes, one with zero opacity and the following one at 100, you will create a transition where the clip passes from 0 to 100% opacity. Plus, the shorter is the length between the two keyframes, the faster the transition will be. By default, two keyframes are automatically added on the extreme edges of the row as well. Managing keyframes is very simple. You can drag them to change their position in time and remove them by right-clicking. To edit the value that one saves, simply select one and change the property on the left. Keyframes selected are in red color. Whenever you want to come back to the static effect, just remove all the keyframes. Right-click on the track and go to remove all keyframes. Let's now see the effects. When you select a clip, the list of the buttons above the timeline changes. All effects are inside Fix Enhance, Power Tools and Keyframe, whatever you choose between video, image and sound clips. Fix Enhance collects all effects to adjust the clip rather than modifying it. For example, in sound clips you can remove noise. In image and video clips, you can adjust lightness, contrast, color and clarity. Simply drag inside the bars or type the values to be more precise. Uncheck the effect to disable the changes done inside a particular section. Check in Compare Video Qualities to compare the video with all settings applied on the left with the original video on the right. When you are done, just click on the cross in the top right corner. All settings will be saved. If you use Power Tools instead, you can modify the clip itself. Let's see it more in detail. If you open Power Tools on the sound clip, you can play it in reverse. Or change its playing speed. This does not change the sound pitch. Use the cross to close the window and save all effects applied. If you open Power Tools on an image clip, you can adjust its rotation. You can use 2D to 3D to transform the clip to a 3D clip. If you open Power Tools on a video clip, you can use Video in Reverse to play it in reverse. Video Crop lets you crop your video clip in order to remove parts that you don't want to use in your project. When you click on Crop Video, set up the rectangle in the preview. All that is outside this won't appear. Use the white nodes to scale, the green one to rotate, and drag from the blue one to move. You can apply keyframes here as well. Just place the small triangle below and click on Add Keyframe. Then, the way the keyframes work is identical to the one seen inside the PIP designer. Drag keyframes to move them in time, and to delete them, just select them and go to Remove Selected Keyframe below. The green arrow will suggest you the motion path you are creating. This has not to be confused with the motion path of the PIP designer. Here you are moving not the whole clip, but you are moving in different parts inside such clip. The blue point then indicates at which point of the arrow you are. Then go to OK to save all. Use video speed to change the playing speed of the video. Use video rotation for rotations instead. Clips with effects applied inside are represented with an orange eye in a corner. Roll over it to see all that is applied. You can change all fix and enhance adjustments in time as well using always the keyframes. Next to Power Tools, you have a button called Keyframe. If you click, the keyframe settings appears. In short, this window collects anything you can change in time using the keyframes, as we saw at the beginning of this video. In Fix and Enhance, you can change in time all the adjustments seen before in the Fix and Enhance window, whereas Clip Attributes does change the object settings properties found inside the PIP designer, like opacity, scale and rotation. Plus there are other sections, for example to adjust the volume. All works in the same way seen. On the right, place the playhead first, then set the value that the keyframe must save, and so on. Pay attention to the row you are working on. Each row is a defined property on the left. To remove all keyframes, just click on the watch icon. Plus, if you added any keyframe through the PIP designer, you will meet these here as well, and eventually modify them. Mind that, if volume changes in time, you will notice an envelope line on the sound clip itself. This indicates how volume goes with time. Each point is indeed a keyframe. So, if you move the point horizontally, you will change its placement in time. If you move vertically, you will change the value of the volume on that point. The same happens if you add keyframes on the opacity level inside image clips. In video clips, you will have both envelope lines, volume for sound part and opacity for frames. This is all. Check out the next video for advanced properties and transitions with Cyberlink PowerDirector 13.